Hello, I'm Li Hao. Today I'm going to share with you how you can get store value outside a Svelte component. You may ask, why? What's the problem with getting a store value outside of Svelte component? Is that hard? Well, let's see at this example. So over here, this is a disclaimer. This is a very contrived example just to demonstrate to you how difficult it is to get the store value outside of Svelte component. Right, so over here, I have a store created using a writable store. And in here, to get the store value within a Svelte component, what I can do is I use a dollar prefix variable to get the value of the store. Right? This automatically subscribes to the store and gets the value. So this variable represents the value of the store. But then I also have a function called calculate double value. I pass in my store. And so this function, I define it within a JavaScript file. So it's outside the Svelte component. So in this function, I want to get the value of the store and then calculate the double of the value of the store. But then how do I get the value of the store? If I do something like this, this does not work because it says $store is not defined. You can't do this over here. You can't subscribe to this store value and get this variable defined over here because this is outside of Svelte component. So how do you get the value of the store then? Well, one way is we can define this variable. Telling you that this variable is going to be the value of the store, I'm going to define a prefix with a dollar, but this got nothing to do with the dollar prefix variable in a Svelte component where it automatically subscribes to the store. Right, so I define this variable and I can subscribe to the store. Subscribe, and then I will get the value of the store over here, right? So I can assign this value to the variable called store. And since I get the value, so this subscribe method will return me an unsubscribe function. And since I already have the value of the store, actually I don't really need to know what's the next value. I just need to know the current value so I can unsubscribe it immediately. So I come over here and call unsubscribe. So at this point of time, I should already get the value of the store in this variable, right? So should, but there is no guarantee, right? It depends on how this store is being defined. So remember when I say in a writable store in the previous video, when you define a subscribe method, you need to call the value of the store immediately. You need to call the function with the current value of the store, because this function, if it's not being called immediately, then the store will still be undefined. So you have to call it immediately so that you can assign to this value immediately, and then right now you can already get use the value of the store, for example store times 2, right? So luckily writable store does that. Writable stores always give you the always will call when you call a subscribe, this callback function will be called synchronously always to give you the current value of the store. So this is how you would get the value of the store at that moment. You subscribe it and then immediately unsubscribes from it, and then you get the value of the store. And actually, there's something that I didn't really talk about, which is if you come over here, if I define this function over here instead, let's remove this. I can't actually get the value of the store using a dollar prefix variable as well. So store has to be a top level variable that, for example, over here, and only you can use dollar prefix to access them, right? So if you're trying to define any function, any variable that has prefix dollar, you will get one. And if you try to access any variable that is any store variable that is not defined in the top level, you will complain as well, because a Svelte component can't really automatically subscribes to this value and then updates it because You may just call this function once, and yeah, things like that, right? You there's no like automatically subscribes and clean up that ties to the component lifecycle, because you can call this function at any point of time and however many times you want, right? And every time when you call the store value, the store variable actually is a different value. So so over here, this warnings just tells us that we probably have to call it a different variable name. So I'm gonna say just underscore instead of dollar prefix, and this will give us the same value as well. And finally, let me comment this out and come back to the previous code. So finally, one thing I want to share is that this piece of code, actually, we already have a util built in from Svelte that does this whole thing over here, and it's called a get. So get will do exactly what we are doing over here, so we don't have to write it ourselves every time. So we can call up, do this instead, and it will still works, right? So get will do the same thing. It will subscribe to SR and then get the value immediately and unsubscribes immediately. So here you go. Here is how you can get a value of a store outside of a Svelte component. So if you like this video, give me a thumbs up. And if you have anything you want to comment, comments down below. And as always, remember to subscribe to my channel so that you get notified when the next video is out. So see ya. Bye bye.